Welcome back to the Hank Strange Situation, Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded.
Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Hank Strange. We're doing another breaking news episode here with AmmoLand and my friend John Crump, writer at AmmoLand. And of course, if you can't tell from his paraphernalia that he's wearing, he's also with the GOA. What's up, John?
Not much, Hank. How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for coming back to the show. What we're going to talk about here is Florida Sheriff creates illegal gun registry. So that's the first thing that we're going to talk about. And this is a story that you guys are working with over at AmmoLand. Before I get into that, unfortunately, folks haven't seen me on the interwebs, on the YouTubes and all that in probably a little over a week. Sadly, my mom passed last Thursday, so I had to go back to New York City to deal with that. I want to thank everyone that reached out to myself and Lola with their condolences. We really appreciate that. It's good to know that we've got lots of good folks out there that care about us, including you, John. I appreciate everything.
No problem.
Yeah. So, all right, let's jump into this here. Florida sheriff creates illegal gun registry. These are a lot of words that don't go together. This is actually not supposed to happen in Florida, right?
No, it's actually a felony that it's happening in Florida. But it looks like the Florida government really doesn't care.
Yeah. So just let's start by laying out the story here for us. Some people might have heard of this. I know that this story has probably been floating around a little bit here. But just lay it out for us from your point of view. I know you take time, you investigate these things. So what do you guys have?
Okay. Basically, Florida has a system called the Finder System. And it was set up after 9/11. And every time a transaction happens at like a pawn shop or something like that, it goes into a database. Firearms information is supposed to be deleted from that database. Mm-hmm. What Sheriff in Charlotte County is doing is taking that information before it's deleting it, copying it, then sending it out to his officers to investigate the people who sold or pawned firearms.
Okay, so let's unpack that a little bit here. So in Florida right now, if you sell a firearm to someone that you know, this is my basic understanding of the law. If you know someone and you know they're a resident in the state of Florida, you can sell it to them without going through background checks. This is what a lot of people like to call a loophole, but basically it's something that allows you to sell your property to someone who you know, like a neighbor, friend, relative, or something like that. You don't have to go through anything. And I know there's people working on closing that. And that's one of the things. The folks trying to close that, we're definitely against it. Now, on the flip side of that, if you buy a gun and then you decide you want to sell that gun, even if you're selling it to a gun store, obviously it's used, so there's set laws for that, right? Or if you want to sell it to a pawn shop, whatever, there's laws that have to that you have to follow when you do that, right? Did you hear me on that, John?
It looks like you froze up there for a minute.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, so let me just go back. So if you have a gun in Florida, you've already bought that gun, gone through background checks or whatever you went through or didn't go through when you bought it. If you decide that you want to trade or sell that gun even to a gun store or a pawn shop, there's certain things that have to happen when you do that, right?
Correct. It has to be put into the Finder system. Mm-hmm. And what happens is, since it's gun data, it's supposed to be deleted from the Finder system once everything mm-hmm. passes. Mm-hmm. But this sheriff is grabbing it before that has a chance to happen.
Right. So what business, like how would the sheriff come into contact with this info in the first place? That's one of the things I'm trying to figure out.
The sheriff has access to the Finder system, so you can look at it for that day and you can see the transactions.
Right. So that might be like in the case of pawning stuff or if you're selling something, if someone, let's say that person stole it, right? Because I know here in Florida, in order to sell things like that, you have to, like if you're going to sell something to a pawn shop, you have to get a fingerprint. If you're going to, I think that works even if you're, like if I'm selling my iPhone to Best Buy, for example, here in Florida, they do a fingerprint thing of you if you've never done it before because you're selling something to them that might have been stolen, right?
Yeah, and that's what goes into the finder system.
Right.
The sheriff is basically data mining all the firearms information out of that system.
Right. So on what authority or what laws is this sheriff using in order to create this? I mean, I'm assuming there's specific laws in Florida that prevent you from doing this, because everyone's always saying that there is some kind of like underground or shadow gun registry, but the law in Florida is supposed to prohibit that, right?
Yeah, section 790.335 of the Florida statute forbids sheriffs from doing this. In fact, it's a felony if they do it.
Right. So I'm trying to see if I could pull that up here just so I could share it with folks. So bear with me here for a second. I'm going to pull that up here on the screen and share it with everyone so they can see that. Okay, let's go here. Boom. So here's the law. And I'll pull that up. The 2019 Florida statute. So the right of individuals to keep and bear arms is guaranteed both under both the Second Amendment to the United States Constitution. Article 1 of the state constitution, right? A list, record, or registry of legally owned firearms or law-abiding firearm owners is not a law enforcement tool and can become an instrument for profiling, harassing, or abusing law-abiding citizens based on their choice to own a firearm and exercise their Second Amendment right to keep and bear arms as guaranteed under the United States Constitution. Further, such a list, record, or registry has the potential to fall into the wrong hands and become a shopping list for thieves. So, I mean, that's, I'm guessing, you know, that's what both of us see that as, right?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. So that statute is supposed to prevent this kind of thing from happening that this Florida sheriff is doing. Do you know how long he's been doing this? Because when I was looking up the story, this looks like this kind of goes back to April. Or does it go back before that?
It goes way back before that. It goes back to 2013.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, it just came to light that they've been doing this.
So they've been doing this for at least 6 years.
Yes. In February, that's when it came to light, and Florida Carry started making inquiries to the AG of Florida about what's going on. Mm. As of right now, the AG have chose not to respond to it.
Okay. So I think you're saying, so Florida Carry broke this story? Are they the first ones to start looking into this?
Yes, I guess they got information. I'm not sure how they acquired the emails, but there were specific emails that they got that showed what they were doing.
Okay, and we have no one can contest the fact that this is being done, right?
That is correct.
Okay, do we know how big, like how many people are in that registry?
We are not sure. We know they've been doing daily emails where they say, here's all the serial numbers and the people who sold firearms or pawned firearms. Go ahead and let's look into these people.
Yeah. Now, is that only for their county or is that for the entire state?
That's just for their county right now.
Okay. So for their county. And what, that was Charlotte County?
Charlotte County, yes. It's south of Tampa.
Yeah, okay, so it's in the Tampa area. If you're in the Tampa area, you need to be really upset about this right now. One of the things we all need to realize here in Florida and lots of places around the country where you have sheriffs are elected. So if you're in Tampa, you've voted for sheriff if you vote, and you probably voted and elected this sheriff. You might want to do something about that since he's breaking the law. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
It's not the same county as Tampa. The county.
I'm sorry.
Is.
Yeah, it's Charlotte County. If you're in that Tampa area, but you're specifically in Charlotte County, you're obviously voting for this guy, right?
Right.
Yeah. So we don't know. We don't know exactly how many people are in there so far.
No, we do not know. I reached out to the public relations officer and have not heard back yet.
Okay. So public relations for the sheriff's department.
Yeah, I am also going to file a FOIA request to try to get that information, but that can take months.
Right, absolutely. That can take a long time. And then have they used this to arrest anyone? Because I'm assuming that they're using this to well, actually, you know what? Tell me why they're using this, because I really don't understand the purpose. Why they're taking this info out of the database that's supposed to disappear and preserving it and then creating this ghost registry that's running alongside everything. Why are they doing that, you think?
Basically, what they're doing is looking for people who become felons, and they can say, well, you know, they had a firearm. Let's go investigate to see if they have a firearm now or not.
Right, I see. So they want to cross-reference it with people in their county that may fall into the felon database, and then they can go back and look at it and say, oh, this person's a felon, but we know they had some kind of interaction with firearms over here. Let's follow up with them and see whether or not they're supposed to have firearms, right?
Correct.
Okay, and have they done that? Have they used that to arrest anyone, to your knowledge?
We do not know that. That's another thing I'm going to FOIA request from them.
Okay.
I inquired about that, and they have not given me an answer, so I might have to force their hand by filing FOIA request.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to assume 6 years, someone must have been caught up in this net. You know,
Sure they were, but I cannot say for sure.
Okay, do we know anyone that's come forward to say, hey, I've been harassed by these guys, and you know, and I didn't understand why, but now I see because I live in this county and I buy and sell guns?
Well, the story's just coming out now, mm-hmm. so I haven't been contacted yet. I'm going to keep an eye out and an ear to the ground to see if I can find anyone who is affected by it. Mm-hmm. If anybody out there watching this has been affected by it, or you were wondering why you keep on being looked into and you live in Charlotte County, mm-hmm. please reach out to me. Facebook's probably the easiest way. Real John Crump on Facebook. I would love to talk to you.
Yeah, absolutely. Please let us know, because these are the kind of things I think that, you know, living here in the state of Florida, this is supposed to be the gunshine state, John.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's supposed to be the gunshine state. Yeah.
Not so much anymore.
No. This seems more like tactics that we see in New York City, we see in lots of places in California. So this clearly is a felony. What do we do? Can we, like, make a citizen's arrest on this sheriff? What do we do to deal with this guy right now, since he's obviously a felon, and he also shouldn't have any guns since he's a felon?
What we need to do, we need to keep pressure on the AG of Florida to act. And mm-hmm. that's one of the reasons why I'm going to write my story and try to get it mm-hmm. out there far and wide as possible, so we can make people aware of this and bring some pressure on the AG and force them to act. Yeah. GOA is already aware of it. I got a statement from Matthew over at GOA, who is the director for state and local affairs, Matthew Patterson.
Mm-hmm.
And GOA is aware of it. They're looking into it, and they also stated that not only is it illegal, but it's unethical.
Absolutely. There's lots of things going on wrong here. When I was looking into the sheriff, I think his name is Pullman?
Yes.
Yeah. When I was looking into him, it seems like a couple of years ago, he fired deputies over there that were misusing county property and things like that, right? They were doing some unethical things. It seems to me definitely, since this is, you know, since this is something that he himself is doing, that he should step down, resign from that post. He shouldn't be there. Definitely the people of Charlotte County in Florida should, you know, start whatever process they need to get rid of this sheriff. And you haven't heard anything back from the sheriff himself either, right?
No, I doubt I will.
Okay.
But I am given the opportunity to respond.
Okay.
That's the reason I'm holding my story for now until...
Okay, when is your story coming out?
It's probably going to drop tomorrow. Today mm-hmm. is Tuesday, so probably Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
That should give them plenty of time to respond.
Yeah. And then we were talking about the Attorney General here in Florida. I think as of this year, it's Ashley Moody. Ashley Moody is our AG, right? Yeah. And she doesn't seem like a very pro-gun, pro-Second Amendment, or even constitutionally aware Attorney General. What do you guys think about that? What's, you know?
Yeah, she's definitely not a friend of gun owners. She ran as a Republican, but she was a Democrat before. And it seems like she still holds some of the Democrat values when it comes to the Second Amendment.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. I think we were talking about this a little bit behind the scenes. You know, I'm not going to fault someone because they were a Democrat and now they're Republican. I'm okay with that. As a matter of fact, for a long time here in Florida, I was registered as a Democrat because Florida has lots of crazy laws, including one where if you register as an independent, which I feel more like an independent, if you register as an independent, you cannot vote in the primaries unless there's an independent running. So lots of times, Lola, for example, did register as an independent, and lots of times she couldn't vote in the primaries because there were no independents running. It's pretty much here. We've got a two-party system just like everywhere else in the country. So it's pretty much either Democrat or Republican. We both did actually switch over to Republican this year. That's all fine. As long as you believe in this little thing right there. You know, that's what matters to me. And I think that the issue that we have going here with our attorney general currently, and to be honest with you, John, I kind of expect this stuff from Democrats, but lots of Republicans in the state of Florida do not value the Constitution and definitely have no respect for the Second Amendment. And to me, in lots of ways, from what I've seen, are anti-gun. What do you think about that?
I would definitely say so. Florida is a really crazy place where you have a Republican governor, a Republican AG, and yet it seems like all the Democrats' plans are passing in Florida.
Yeah.
With the support of the AG and the governor.
Yeah, it seems in a lot of ways they're rhinos. They're de facto Democrats, but they just switch over to the Republican Party because, hey, you know, the Democratic Party is crowded. You know, everyone's in that space. Let's go over here. But they bring their same values instead of bringing like values that should stick to the Constitution. It's disappointing to me. And I'm trying to do things to make folks aware in the state of Florida as well as around the country that this stuff is going on and then start doing something about it. I think that starts with voting. We vote for these people. You know, and we have to hold them accountable. We got lots of stuff that I thought that was anti-Second Amendment from Rick Scott. I refuse to vote for him for Senate, although he's there. I don't vote for him. I don't support him. I encourage people to push back and definitely not vote for these people. And or you can reach out to them and say, look, what's going on here, you know? You should be able to reach out to your elected officials and tell them that you don't like things like this happening. And if you're in Charlotte County, Florida, you definitely need to reach out to your sheriff and find out from him what's going on. And when election time comes, do not vote for this person. If you believe in the Constitution, the Second Amendment, you believe in freedom, do not support people who do not believe in that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, so... you know, your article's coming out tomorrow, so you guys will probably see this video once the article is out. We've been working with AmmoLand, of course. John and everyone else at AmmoLand have been very gracious and kind.
It's a great partnership.
Yes, absolutely. I appreciate you guys doing that. So let us know right here in the article, in this video, whether you see it on YouTube or anywhere else, let us know what you guys think about this de facto gun registry list. This is probably, John, not just happening in this county. Florida has a kajillion counties the last time I counted, right?
I think 63 when I was looking into it. Yeah. And we are investigating to see if we can find any other instances mm-hmm. of this happening in other counties around Florida.
Yeah, absolutely. If anyone out there knows about this happening, let us know. Comment on it here. Well, yeah, 63 counties. There's a lot of counties here. And if we see this one thing, I would find it very hard to believe that it's isolated to Charlotte County. I would think it's going on in other places. And to be honest with you, John, probably came from somewhere outside of Florida, the idea to do this.
You're probably right.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you have any last comments before we get out of here?
No, I'm pretty good. Just look for my article to drop, and if you can share it just to get the people and knowing what's going on, it would help out not only me by sharing the article, but it will help out the people in Florida who mm-hmm. this is happening to, and maybe force the AG's hand into doing something to prevent this.
Yeah, absolutely. And then also make sure you keep in touch with John if you've got stories. I know, I'm gonna try to keep your inbox full, John.
I know. Yeah. Yeah, I was talking to Hank, and I went to bed at 2:30 last night. My inbox is empty, and when I woke up at 6 a.m., there's 23 emails with people with stories. Of the 23, I've been through 18 of them so far, and they're all bunk. But,
yeah,
you know, every once in a while, you have that little gem out there, mm-hmm. and that's what I'm looking for, that little diamond in the rough.
Yeah, absolutely. If you have a valid story, if you have something, do it. Don't waste John's time because really and truly, he's got a lot of work to do. And then also, I know I would like to take this opportunity before we get out of here, John. There is an event coming up in D.C., I believe. What is it, November 2nd?
November 2nd. Yeah. It's the rally for 2A. It's mm-hmm. going to be a massive. People are coming from all over the country, and I'm going to be there. A lot of people are going to be there. Eric from Iraq Vet 888 is going to be there as well, mm-hmm. and there's going to be great speakers. I don't think the speaker list is public yet, but I know some of the people that are speaking, and you don't want to miss these people speaking. And this is a chance to show people in D.C. that the Second Amendment community is alive. It's not sponsored by any one group. In fact, if you look on the website, secondamendmentrally.com, that's 2ndamendmentrally.com, you won't see a name of an organizer or anything, and that is intentional because it's about bringing the community together under one banner.
Absolutely. I think because I have some previous stuff that we planned, I'm not going to be able to make it. But I think here's what I'm going to do. I believe everyone should try to do something for this effort. So for my part, I'm going to try to promote it as much as possible on the podcast. We are going to have folks that are going to be there that are organizing it on, and we'll try to get the message out to everyone. I think it's really important to get as many people to turn out to this rally as possible. Of course, I wish that I had known that this was coming up. I kind of like made these plans a long time ago. But we're going to do everything we can to promote it, reach out to people out there. And even if you can't make it, please help share the message and get it out there, because we really do need the gun community to show up with all these different things that we're doing, not just this one, other efforts that we're making. Any final words?
Nope, I'll be live streaming for a GOA and also doing interviews to be released on the GOA YouTube page.
Awesome. Yeah, when you do that, make sure you tag me, man.
Definitely.
Yeah, no matter what I'm doing, I got my phone. I could definitely reshare something, get the message out there. Okay, thanks, everyone. Like I said, don't forget to leave your comments here and your opinion of all of this. If you're in Charlotte County, please let us know. Don't forget to subscribe here to the channel and ring the bell so that you could be notified. Thanks a lot, John. Shout out to AmmoLand. Make sure you guys follow AmmoLand News. That's it. We're out of here. Peace.